All right, welcome to Box Elder High School again here tonight. I say again, this is round two here, our doubleheader. We got the boys coming up here against Clearfield as well. I'm going to start off the same place I did with the girls there, Greg. There we go. Now I can hear better a little bit. You know, I mentioned that the girls' game was going to be a good game, and it was a good game. It was a hard-fought, back and forth both ways. Defense was excellent on both sides, and we had a number six versus number seven in the state RPI playing together. This one's not much different. Box Elder is ranked number 18 in the RPI, and we've got Clearfield ranked number 20. So, again, two really closely matched teams. So, I think we're in for another great game here coming up, Greg.
Yeah, we got some excitement in the gym from that girls' leftover game. We got the crowd fired up, so let's just keep it rolling.
I think we will. We got some common opponents here. We got five common opponents so far here in the season. We're going to start off with Bear River. Bear River, we played them just before Christmas. They thumped on us pretty good, 61-47. I would say right here, with the Bear River game, if that's all you're looking at, advantage goes to Clearfield.
Mm-hmm.
So they beat Clearfield 42-30, so an 8-point game versus, you know, 14 for Box Elder. Second game that we're going to look at. It was Box Elder's first game of the year at Weber. That was pretty close. 73-55 is what Weber beat Box Elder. And Weber beat Clearfield 69-53. Fairly close.
Yeah.
Third game we're going to look at. We had Box Elder beat Bountiful 75-72. Bountiful beat Clearfield 80-71. There's a caveat in there. And I don't know for sure, but I know that I believe that Sachiwala did not play against Box Elder.
Oh.
So you're taking out a great athlete out of that game. And so, scores show advantage Box Elder. Is it really? I don't know.
Another thing to look at is Clearfield played them at home, whereas Box Elder played them at Bountiful. So
yep.
It's always harder on the road.
It is. The other game, Woods Cross. Box Elder beat Woods Cross at Woods Cross by one, 50-49. Woods Cross, again, at Woods Cross again here. Woods Cross beat Clearfield 49-47.
Another close one.
It was close.
Both sides.
You know, barely an advantage for Box Elder there. Northridge, the other one. Northridge beat Box Elder 64-58. So, 6-point win for Northridge. And let's see, Northridge, they beat Clearfield 54-35. Pretty good advantage, Box Elder on that one. So, I'm giving Box Elder a slight advantage in this game. They are ranked 2 points higher in the RPI, and the games where I would give, the credit towards Clearfield in the beginning of the season, or the closer ones, Box Elder had a not so good record in the preseason. They came out of the preseason, started playing conference play, and it's like a light switch turned on or something. They've been playing very well and have been winning very well. Box Elder's record is 5-9. Clearfield's record 4-10. So you know, looking at it that way, like I said, I give Box Elder a slight advantage. Where it's at home, that's got to be a little bit to give as well. So easy game, absolutely not. Too much riding on it for that. We're going to step away for a quick commercial break, and then we'll be right back with some more.
Earning your degree doesn't have to be complex. USU Brigham City lets you stay close to home and save money. As an Aggie, you'll have access to a personalized education with student support from faculty mentors. Let us help you achieve your goals your way. On campus, online, this is your U State.
We've been in business here at Gillis Funeral Chapel for the last 18 years. We do aftercare, and that's where Melanie Christie will go in and meet with a family after the services have been completed, and she'll help them with Social Security, help them file for life insurance, help them with federal government employee work. We go through credit cards. We help the family with all that transition that's coming out.
Kent's Market is your hometown grocery store meeting your everyday needs, whether it's fresh produce, quality meats, or a made-from-scratch bakery. Their excellent customer service will meet your needs, even at their pharmacy. Kent's has stores located in Brigham City, Tremont, Roy, and Clearfield. Check us out on Facebook or on our website, www.kentsgrocery.com. Oh, and don't forget, every Friday, it's Fritter Friday. All fritters are 2 for $1. Kent's Market, locally owned and operated.
Todd Filson. Paul Winterton.
Stephanie Haley.
Adam
with Detroit Regeneration.
Joint Regeneration Center of Utah.
Our team is delivering the best care possible to patients that are suffering from osteoarthritis, degenerative joint disease, and also looking to optimize their sports performance.
I firmly believe that the body is designed to heal itself. So PRP, hyaluronic, those things are very safe and working with the body to heal.
Welcome to Joint Regeneration Center of Utah.
Nucor is a great company. They care about their people. They care about the environment.
I've never been restricted to fall in a box. I've never been told that I can't do something.
I saw it as a great opportunity to develop a career.
You create your own destiny at Nucor.
We're building something bigger out here at Nucor. Come join us.
The following was performed by everyday riders like you. Please try it home.
Matt's a straight ripper.
I heard the turbo and I was just giggling under my helmet.
Look at that.
I look like a pro. Woo-hoo!
Dude, I love that thing.
Starting lineups for tonight's game. First, for the visiting Clearfield Falcons, number 4, Peyton Cotter. Number 10, Trace Hansen. Number 21, Jackson Bishop. Number 24, Tavian Singletary. And number 31, Chase McNeil. The Falcons are coached by Scott McLaughlin. 2, Jordan Mason. Number 3, Elijah Percy. Number 15, Carter Buchanan. Number 33, Mason Jepson. And number 35, Max Isaacson. The Bees are coached by Russell Beck.
Greg, it's round 2 coming up here.
Let's do it. Excitement.
Isaacson, I think he's got, just maybe an inch or so on McNeil out there. Or is close. McNeil's got him by about 50 pounds. Isaacson wins the tip.
Carter Buchanan in the starting lineup.
Impressive. He works hard. He plays hard. Inside, Isaacson puts it up, no good. McNeil with some influence in there. And Kersey with a deflection out of bounds. Call a foul on Isaacson on there, but he had a good block, I think.
Foul is called on Max Isaacson, his first. Tavian Singletary.
So Singletary goes to the free throw line. See if we can get a point on the board. One for two for Singletary.
Little mid-court pressure put on by Clearfield.
Inside, count the bucket. They wanted one more. Three ball, no good. Mason the rebound. And the turnover. In the hands of Hansen. Mason got his hands in there a little bit on it. Shot clock down to 5. And passed it out of bounds. Box Elder ball with 3 on the shot clock.
Great defense, Box Elder, on that possession.
So for Box Elder, we've got Kersey that leads the way scoring. He's followed by Max Isaacson. Kersey's almost 19 a game. And there's 2 of them right there.
Great penetration.
Isaacson follows with almost 14. Wilkinson after that with almost 10. Hansen scored that 3-pointer. Box Elder ball. Hansen wanted to jump. On the Clearfield side, Peyton Carter leads the way, scoring with just under 14 a game. And he's followed by Trace Hansen. And almost got the and one. Hansen, I believe, will be the culprit on that one.
Trace Hansen is first. Max Isaacson shoots two.
Isaacson at the crumble cookie free throw line.
Stay tuned for the halftime show sponsored by Crumble Cookie.
We like crumble cookies.
Yes.
Isaacson, goose egg from the free throw line. He's going to have to try a different flavor of cookie. That's all there is to it.
Yeah.
Zone defense now for Box Elder, switching it up on him.
Good recovery by Isaacson.
And then good comeback also by Buchanan to pick that one up. Wilkinson came in, ball missed, and got stuffed pretty good there by McNeil. They said they got McNeil's head on that one.
Jepson
didn't think so.
Chase McNeil.
McNeil arrows one in.
Derek Nesson.
Nesson comes in to replace Isaacson. Two for two for McNeil. Pressure defense there by Jackson Bishop forces a turnover. Low scoring game, 4-6. Count the bucket, Jepson with another foul. This is not the same refereeing as the girls game.
They're calling a lot more than the girls.
Basket counts. Peyton Cotter shoots one.
Caden Anderson gets set to come in. Cotter with the bucket and the free throw. Timeout Box Elder, Falcons by five.
We've been in business here at Gillis Funeral Chapel for the last 18 years. We do aftercare, that's where Melanie Christie will go in and meet with the family after the services have been completed, and she'll help them with Social Security, help them file for life insurance, help them with federal government employee work. We go through credit cards, we help the family with all that transition that's coming out.
All right, we are back. Box Elder just needs to get used to playing with that pressure defense put on by Clearfield. A little bit of early foul trouble, at least for Jepson. That'll be a foul. Kersey goes to the crumble cookie free throw line. They're going to call that one on Hittle.
Fouls on Tavian Singletary. His first.
Singletary. I must he must have had his numbers backwards. Either that or I didn't see all the fingers. Add another one for Kersey. Misses that one. Off Clearfield, Box Elder ball.
Isaacson
comes back in, replaces Buchanan. Missed layup there by Isaacson. And wide open underneath there is McNeil. Somebody did not have their man. Mason comes back in, Anderson will sit. Up, shot, no good. Long rebound, Cotter had it way out front. McNeil kind of had his way in there. Little hook going on, but no call. Mason from the corner, no good. 13-5, Falcons. Three ball, in and out by Wilkinson. And steal there, Nesson and Isaacson, and there's gonna be a foul. I believe this one's on Bishop, it is. Nesson makes the first one after a number of bounces.
Spencer Jones and Davis Wall.
If I'm not mistaken, most of Box Elder's points have come from the free throw line in the first quarter. They can't buy a field goal.
They've got two field goals out of the six so far. Missed shot there by Singletary. Takes it out of bounds. Clearfield with a 31-second shot clock. And a missed pass. Kersey with the ball. Inside. Oh! I can't believe they did not call that.
Yeah. They're going to call
and then they call that. Coach Beck is not happy on that other end, and I can't say I blame him. That was a bad call, or a bad no call. Somebody goes up for a dunk and gets shoved down. I don't care which book it is, it's a foul.
Yep.
Michael Creel in for the Falcons.
Shot made there by Wool. And they gave that one to him. That wasn't near the foul he got on the last one.
That was an impressive assist by Mason.
That was a great shot. Drodge the foul. It's getting a little chippy out there. The officials having a word with him. Wilkinson trying to get in a spot and kept getting shoved out. Makes the three-point play. Creel for three, no good. Rebound, Wool. And finally, ball ends up in the hands of Isaacson. Nesson misses bad. Six on the shot clock. Three ball air balls and 35 second shot clock violation on Clearfield. McNeil coming back in. Three-pointer, corner, no good. And that ends the quarter. After one, Box Elder 9, Clearfield 14. We'll be right back.
Kent's Market is your hometown grocery store meeting your everyday needs, whether it's fresh produce, quality meats, or a made-from-scratch bakery. Their excellent customer service will meet your needs, even at their pharmacy. Kent's has stores located in Brigham City, Tremont, Roy, and Clearfield. Check us out on Facebook or on our website, www.kentsgrocery.com. Oh, and don't forget, every Friday, it's Fritter Friday. All fritters are two for $1. Kent's Market, locally owned and operated.
Investing in your education is an investment in yourself. Open doors with a degree from Utah State University and find your path to a more rewarding future. Reach your goals by attending USU Brigham City while staying close to home and saving money. Give yourself a chance to see the return. Your way, on campus, online. This is your U State.
All right, welcome back for quarter number two. Falcons with a 5-point lead going into the second quarter. And it's Falcon ball to start it off.
What do you think the Bees need to do to get back into this?
They got to just take care of the ball. I think McNeil is causing some problems underneath. Out of bounds, Box Elder ball.
Good thought, throwing the ball on the Box Elder guy that was on the ground.
But he was out of bounds to start with.
Yep,
so.
Yep.
No, that was a good block. Isaacson had his hands up on there.
Yep.
Nesson for three. No good. Rebound. Wool going the other way. Three ball no good by Cotter. First quarter definitely wasn't the best of the Bees. But you got to give some credit to Clearfield. Short from the corner. Box Elder ball. Last touch by the Falcons. Nice pass inside to Isaacson.
That's a beautiful inbound play.
That was a great inbound play. Nobody could backside him. Nesson with the foul.
That was called on Derek Nesson.
One on Nesson. McNeil at the free throw line. McNeil misses the first, gets a chance for another one. I still think this can help improve free throw shooting percentages overall, Greg.
I do too.
Warm up on the first one. Missed them both, and there's going to be a foul. Whoa, trying to get over the top of Isaacson. Not going to happen.
Mm-mm. Clearfield continues to put pressure on the inbound passes.
Crowd wants a foul, didn't get it. And the floater on the baseline by Kersey.
Not much room down there, but he made the best of it.
And the steal, credit Kersey and Buchanan. Buchanan gets two on the other end. Box Elder now up one.
That's the kind of play you were just talking about. Isaacson completely thrown off that shot.
He threw off the shot, then he turned around and ran and grabbed the rebound.
Good.
Out of bounds. Last touch by Hansen. It's Box Elder ball on the side.
They continue to double Elijah up on the top when he has the ball.
Over the top, Isaacson, reverse, count the bucket, he's fouled.
Beautiful entry pass by Buchanan.
And it was just a reverse layup for Isaacson. McNeil not happy about the call.
Fouls on Chase McNeil, his first.
His first foul,
Max Isaacson shoots.
I don't know that it's worth pulling him out of the game for that, but.
Yeah.
I think he's definitely one of their strong points against us in there, so. Corner shot, no good. Nesson the foul again, that'll be two on him. That'll send Hansen to the free throw line.
Fouls on Derek Nesson, his second.
So Nesson gets two. That's going to bring in Jepson.
Who also has two as well in the first quarter.
First one's good for Hansen.
Mason Jepson in for the Bees. Peyton Carter in for the Falcons.
Both of them are good for Hansen.
For
Kersey taking his time.
Defense of the Falcons backs off.
Wide open for rebound, Jepson. Inside.
Trying that reverse again over the head.
B's up by two. Just under five to go here in the second quarter. Coach Beck wanted an offensive foul. Push off there by Jones. Jones for three, no good. Kersey the rebound.
Buchanan was open on the baseline for just a minute.
And he... They're going to call a foul on Kersey.
It looked like he was just standing there.
I think he was leaning in a little bit. Coach Beck not happy, having words with the officials. His feet were stationary, I'll give him that.
Yeah.
But I think he leaned just a little bit into him. We'll take a quick timeout. We'll be right back.
We've been in business here at Gillis Funeral Chapel for the last 18 years. We purchased the mortuary, the funeral chapel, in 2001. My wife Lori and I have always felt that family is important, and when you have a family-owned funeral home, you get personal attention than you do than the big corporate funeral homes that are in the area. But we like to go one step further ahead.
Hi, I'm Ryan from CoverUp. We offer embroidery and screen printing to help you promote your business. We can also help you with your church or school groups, family reunions, or any other occasion that might require a t-shirt. So come in and see us at 47 South Main in Brigham City or 115 West Main in Tremonton.
All right, coming back here. That's only Kersey's first foul. So not too worried about that. Hanson at the free throw line again.
Trace Hanson shoots two.
Chance to tie the game. Brings it within one. Mason gave Hanson a little spank on the butt there, to, like a good shot. I wonder if they know each other.
Mm-hmm.
Or if he's trying to get in his head. Two hands all over him, and that's going to be a foul right there on Drodge.
Fouls on Hanson. Fouls on Hanson. Number 44, Samuel Drogi.
Drogi is what the announcer calls it. I did not check pronunciations before. And another one on Drogi. He's going, what do I do?
Isaacson.
Keep your arm straight up and you don't have to worry about it.
Yeah, Isaacson's just like flinging it up over the top of his head.
Isaacson shoots two. That's three on him. So that will bring McNeil back in. Wilkinson comes in as well. B's lead up to three. Halfway through the second quarter. Good hustle. Good rebound by Kersey. Oh, man. He got slammed by Cotter.
Was that Buchanan?
Yeah. Granted, he was going for the ball, but his arm came down and just slammed Buchanan to the ground.
Carter Buchanan shoots two.
They're going to have to be careful or somebody's going to get hurt in this game.
It's pointing in that direction, isn't it?
That is not the direction we want this to go.
And that puts Box Elder in the bonus for the rest of the quarter.
Buchanan makes the first one. Bishop coming in and plays a Hansen.
Crumble Cookie free throw line. Showing up big time.
It's a good thing Buchanan plays football. That's all I can say.
Yeah.
Two for two for Buchanan. He's going to, after that, his left wrist is a little sore, I think. Sumko comes in his place. Another football player. Good defense there by the Bees. I think his foot was on the line on that one, but they're giving 3 points to Bishop. You get Kersey inside down low, you cannot stop him. He is strong.
Three Falcons surrounded him and he still put it up and in.
Wants another one, gets his own rebound this time as Bishop. Three ball, no good. And ends up in the hands of Wilkinson. Wilkinson's fouled. I believe Cotter is going to get called on this one. It is. So Wilkinson to the Crumble Cookie free throw line.
Cotter is first. Trevor Wilkinson shoots two.
In and out for Wilkinson. Wilkinson makes the second one. And a block by Isaacson and a Cotter foul. That's one of those frustration fouls.
Grabbing his arm, yeah, that's good. Good defense for Isaacson. He's hard to shoot around.
Well, I mean, look at it. Isaacson got him by 8 inches.
Yep, and Isaacson's been good at the free throw line, so let's go.
We like Crumble Cookies, just like that one.
2:02 left, and that's Box Elder up by 6.
Cotter will take a seat. Creel comes in.
Michael Creel returns for the Falcons.
And Isaacson's finding the rhythm at that free throw line. Good switch there. Feet got caught up there by Sumko. Good defense on that. McNeil had it open. Good block there by McNeil. Good defense again by Isaacson down there. Short, Isaacson the rebound. Here comes Kersey. Takes it up. Isaacson kind of on McNeil's back on that one.
He didn't like that much,
No, he
did
didn't.
He?
Kind of threw an elbow to get him off.
Yeah. Under a minute to go here in the second quarter.
Three ball good by Creel that time. 2-point ball game. Sumko, corner three, no good. Rebound, put back, good by Wilkinson.
It was a good pass by Sumko.
Yeah, that's what he's doing.
Crowd wants travel.
They got a jump ball. Box Elder with it, with 4.2 on the clock. Ryan Jensen comes in for Box Elder. And he gets blocked as time expires by Creel. So halftime, Box Elder 29, Clearfield 25. So that was a 20-point quarter for Box Elder.
Wow.
And an 11-point quarter for Clearfield.
Need to keep that matched for third and fourth quarter.
So Box Elder was able to get something going there. And I don't know what's coming up here for halftime.
Looks like a bunch of
it doesn't look
sitting
like
around,
cheerleaders
huh?
are doing anything. I know we got our Crumble Cookie halftime show, if we can get our Crumble Cookie halftime people to come.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to invite you out on the court.
Okay, they're just going to start shooting. We're going to hear from some of our sponsors, and then we'll get our Crumble Cookie halftime show gathered up here.
Investing in your education is an investment in yourself. Open doors with a degree from Utah State University and find your path to a more rewarding future. Reach your goals by attending USU Brigham City while staying close to home and saving money. Give yourself a chance to see the return. Your way, on campus, online. This is your U State.
Kent's Market is your hometown grocery store meeting your everyday needs, whether it's fresh produce, quality meats, or a made-from-scratch bakery. Their excellent customer service will meet your needs, even at their pharmacy. Kent's has stores located in Brigham City, Tremont, Roy, and Clearfield. Check us out on Facebook or on our website, www.kentsgrocery.com. Oh, and don't forget, every Friday, it's Fritter Friday. All fritters are 2 for $1. Kent's Market. Locally owned and operated.
We've been in business here at Gillis Funeral Chapel for the last 18 years. We do aftercare, and that's where Melanie Christie will go in and meet with a family after the services have been completed, and she'll help them with Social Security, help them file for life insurance, help them with federal government employee work. We go through credit cards. We help the family with all that transition that's coming out.
Nucor is a great company. They care about their people. They care about the environment.
I've never been restricted to fall in a box. I've never been told that I can't do something.
I saw it as a great opportunity to develop a career.
You create your own destiny at Nucor.
We're building something bigger out here at Nucor. Come join us.
My name is Sean Filson.
Paul Winterton.
Stephanie. Haley.
Adam with the Joint Regeneration.
Joint Regeneration.
Joint Regeneration.
Joint Regeneration Center of Utah.
Our team is delivering the best care possible to patients that are suffering from osteoarthritis, degenerative joint disease, and also looking to optimize their sports performance.
I firmly believe that the body is designed to heal itself. So PRP, hyaluronic, those things are very safe and working with the body to heal.
Welcome to Joint Regeneration Center of Utah.
We've been in business here at Gillis Funeral Chapel for the last 18 years. We purchased the mortuary, the funeral chapel, in 2001. My wife Lori and I have always felt that family is important, and when you have a family-owned funeral home, you get personal attention than you do than the big corporate funeral homes that are in the area. But we like to go one step further ahead.
The following was performed by everyday riders like you. Please try it home.
Matt's a straight ripper.
I heard the turbo and I was just giggling under my helmet.
Look at that.
I look like a pro. Woohoo!
Dude, I love that thing.
For a loved one currently suffering from chronic knee pain, arthritis, or osteoarthritis of the knee, has physical therapy, surgery, steroid injections, ibuprofen, and other NSAIDs failed to provide relief.
All right, welcome to our Crumble Cookie halftime show here tonight. Crumble Cookies of the Week we have here. We got the Kentucky Buttercream Cookie, Milk Chocolate Chip. We've got a Wedding Cake. We've got a Vanilla Sugar Cookie. We've got Brownie Sundae. And we've got a Graham Cracker Sandwich. You guys like Graham Crackers? Who we got here? What's your name?
James.
James, all right. What's your name?
Timmery.
What was it again?
Timmery.
Timmery, all right. And who do we have behind?
James.
James, Grandpa.
Grandpa works.
Okay, who else do we have?
Reagan.
Reagan and?
Brianna.
Brianna, all right. We're going to start with the youngest first. How's that?
Okay. I'm not.
She's younger, okay. Which one do you think is good? Okay, take apart. Go ahead and take a bite. You can take one too. Oh, he likes brownie sundaes. Is that good? That one must be good. You took a big bite. All right. Okay. Kentucky buttercream for Jim. What do you think, Jim?
Really good.
All right. Okay, Reagan, you're up. Sugar cookie for Reagan.
That's pretty good.
Pretty good? Brianna, come on.
That one's already been chosen. We'll do this one.
You can pick whatever one you want.
We want this one. If I can get it. Ooh, that one's going to fall apart.
Oh, you need a bigger bite.
Ow.
There you go. Great. What do you think of that?
Oh.
You can tell us. We'll let you.
Yummy.
Okay, good. All right. You guys can pick another one. Which one do you want to try?
Try a different one now.
You just like that one? Okay, which one do you want to try?
Try a different one.
All right, vanilla sugar. Okay, Jim. Vanilla sugar for Jim. Jim, you got, which one's your favorite?
I would say the sundae.
They're both good? Okay, Jim, which one's your favorite? You can say.
I don't remember what it was.
Kentucky buttercream.
Way good.
All right. Okay, Reagan, round two. Here we go. Taking Jim's word for it. Which one's better?
All right, gotta.
What's that?
I gotta taste it.
Take a bigger bite. You can taste it better.
No. I like this one better.
You like that one better? All right. Kentucky buttercream's getting some votes here.
Okay, my chocolate chip one.
Chocolate chip for Brianna. Which one's your favorite? Which one's your favorite?
Give me chocolate chip.
Chocolate chip.
All
right. Okay, what's everybody's favorite kind of cookie?
Crumble.
Crumble, and I love them. They are good.
All right, thank you very much, you guys. Greg, we're going to send it back to you over there, and we'll be back for half number two.
All right, Bruce, halftime show is over. Teams are back on the court. We apologize for that camera that was overheating. So we had to use the camera that was up here. But we got 25 seconds left. Ready to start the second half.
All right, I missed a little bit here. Greg, sorry. Greg's got his mouth full of crumble cookie, too.
That wedding cake one hit the spot.
I like the graham crackers sandwich.
Ooh, there's one more of those in there. I'll have to try that one next.
Isaacson steps back for a three off the front of the rim. Good defense by Mason. A miss by McNeil. Crowd wanted a foul on that one, didn't get it. In and out by Hansen. Jordan Mason with the rebound. Inside, nice pass to Buchanan from Jepson for two. And just like that, timeout called by the Falcons. We'll be right back.
We've been in business here at Gillis Funeral Chapel for the last 18 years. We purchased the mortuary, the funeral chapel, in 2001. My wife Lori and I have always felt that family is important, and when you have a family-owned funeral home, you get personal attention than you do than the big corporate funeral homes that are in the area. but we like to go one step further ahead.
Hi, I'm Ryan from CoverUp. We offer embroidery and screen printing to help you promote your business. We can also help you with your church or school groups, family reunions, or any other occasion that might require a t-shirt. So come in and see us at 47 South Main in Brigham City or 115 West Main in Tremonton.
All right, we are back. Box Elder, 4 points already in third quarter. They've got a 4-0 run here in the third quarter. Rebound, Singletary. Three ball short. And in the hands of Kersey. Nice pass to Jepson. Jepson comes in from behind to score two.
Kersey's just been pushing it. Love it. Keeping that tempo up.
Nice tap there by Singletary for two.
There goes Kersey again.
Nice pass. Got himself underneath, stretched back out from under the basket to score that. Three ball by Hansen. Calling that an offensive foul on Isaacson.
That's unfortunate because the ball went in after he made that good pass.
Jump ball. Kersey went after that. That's where Kersey's size is very important next to McNeil. He was down low right where he was dribbling that ball, able to grab it.
Did you see who came in?
Drogi? Is
yeah,
that how they said it?
I think so.
I hope that's right. I don't want to be saying it wrong. Mason, corner three, no good. Mason Jepson, the rebound, way downtown for Kersey, in and out.
What game was it when Kersey was making all those from that far out?
I can't remember, but he was having... Hansen bounces all around the rim and doesn't go. I thought he would pass that out and it got touched. But
yeah, that's what I thought.
Official had his back to, or could not see two with his angle.
Two of the Falcon defenders in front of him.
Hansen. No call on that one either, so they're letting him play.
A little bit different than the first half.
I still hope they don't let it get out of hand.
Yeah.
Three ball Cotter is good. Back to a 4-point game now. Buchanan, three ball corner, count it!
He's getting it back.
That three-pointer brought to you by Brigham Community Pharmacy. Cotter, two more. I can't believe there's no foul on that. Offensive foul going the other way. Hansen. Buchanan draws a lot of offensive fouls. He would have been just fine had he not thrown his whole body into him to create space.
The energy level is taking it up about five notches in the second half. Coaches have got their teams out ready to play.
This is a good game.
I think that's our first three-pointer of the game, too, that Buchanan just made on that last possession.
I think so. I think you're right.
Need to get a few more of those.
Buchanan through the middle. Scoop it up. No good. Drogi the rebound. Hansen or Singletary passes to Kersey. I don't think he meant to do that, though.
Yeah. Did Wilkinson get his hand on it a little bit?
I don't think so.
Huh. Isaacson couldn't even get his hands up for the rebound. He was being held.
Yep. Drogi misses. Isaacson the rebound. Hansen got his hand on it. Hansen had Kersey way up in the air.
There we go.
Count the bucket! He has fouled twice. That was good.
I apologize for the listeners. I bet you just blew a few eardrums out on that one. That was good.
Bishop gets called on the foul. Coach McLaughlin not happy. Gets asked to come back to his bench.
He had two defenders there, one hanging on him, and he still got it in.
Kersey is strong. He is strong.
Crumble cookie free throw line. There we go.
He's got the right flavor, that's for sure. Student section getting into it. Kersey with a steal. Buchanan ended up on the ground. Didn't see what happened there.
I didn't either. He's slow to get up, though. Hope he's okay.
On the line right there, Box Elder ball. These refs have got to start calming this game down or it's going to get in trouble.
It's heading that direction.
Yeah, there's some major physicality. We'll be right back.
My name is Sean Filson.
Paul Winterton.
Stephanie.
Haley.
Adam with the Joint Regeneration.
Joint Regeneration Center of Utah.
Our team is delivering the best care possible to patients that are suffering from osteoarthritis, degenerative joint disease, and also looking to optimize their sports performance.
I firmly believe that the body is designed to heal itself. So PRP, hyaluronic, those things are very safe and working with the body to heal.
Welcome to Joint Regeneration Center of Utah.
We've been in business here at Gillis Funeral Chapel for the last 18 years. We purchased the mortuary, the funeral chapel, in 2001. My wife Lori and I have always felt that family is important, and when you have a family-owned funeral home, you get personal attention than you do than the big corporate funeral homes that are in the area. But we like to go one step further ahead.
All right, Bees are back, ready to play. Bees with an 8-point lead and the ball. 1:32 left to go here in the third. Try it again. Good hustle there by Jones to try and get that out.
Hey,
calling a foul on Sumco. Late whistle or something. Second Bucks under team foul. Nice step up there for Wool. Inside. 2 points for Isaacson. Should have been one more.
Yep.
And a major swap by Nesson.
Wow. Wow.
He sent that ball over to the bench. And he didn't even come close to touching whoever shot that.
Yep.
Kersey's going to get a 47.7 second rest.
He's had his jets on this quarter, so well deserved.
Oh, somebody's little girl's on the floor. They had to stop play. Good yep. call by the officials.
She wanted a piece of that blocked ball that Nesson did.
Not sure where she belongs there. I think she found mommy. Good job for at least protecting the two-year-old. Good shot that time by Drogi. Samuel Drogi.
Shot clock's turned off. End of the third quarter.
Wilkinson for three, no good. Sumco for the second foul.
Fouls on Daxton. Sumco, his second.
14 seconds to go here in the third
Only
quarter.
Five fouls called in this quarter all the way around. Nesson with another block. And no good on that prayer by Wool. Boxelder up 45-39 after three. We'll be right back.
For a loved one currently suffering from chronic knee pain, arthritis, or osteoarthritis of the knee, has physical therapy, surgery, steroid injections, ibuprofen, and other NSAIDs failed to provide relief, then you may be a candidate for our Advanced Arthritis Relief Protocol. The AARP program utilizes the latest fluoroscopic guidance technology to deliver a new joint fluid supplement that cushions the knee and reduces pain. Specialized knee bracing is then applied to unload the knee and increase joint space. Finally, advanced rehabilitative therapies are performed to strengthen the muscles and ligaments of the knee. When combined, these treatments have helped many patients reduce or even eliminate their joint pain and return to normal active lifestyles. The best part is the AARP program is covered by most insurance, including Medicare. Tired of living with knee pain? Then call the number on your screen right now to see if you qualify for our Advanced Arthritis Relief Protocol.
All right, fourth quarter, getting ready to go here. I believe it's Clearfield ball to start things off. That's the direction the officials are pointing as well.
How are we going to close this out tonight, Bruce?
Boxeller just got to take care of the basketball.
Take care of the ball.
You know, no turnovers and, you know, just keep attacking.
Yeah.
You know, keep attacking inside. You know, you got to be strong with the ball because it's a physical game out there.
Yep.
And a miss by McNeil and a rebound by Isaacson, and here comes Kersey. Three ball, corner, no good. Rebound all the way back up to Mason. Mason over the top of McNeil for two.
What a beautiful floater by Mason.
The shortest guy on the court just floats it over.
McNeil didn't want anything to do with Isaacson on that play.
Three ball there by Hansen.
But it opened up that outside shot. 5-point game.
Guys, our rebound goes to
Buchanan.
Buchanan, three ball, no good. Three ball's just not falling for the Bees tonight.
Yeah, we've only called Brigham Community Pharmacy once tonight.
Tavian Singletary in for Clearfield.
Got to get some help down low. That will work. Kersey all the way for 2 points after that ball gets tapped out by Isaacson.
That was 47 seconds that you said. Give him a good rest.
Cotter for three. They're trading twos and threes right now. Pass a little high for Kersey. Ten-footer good for McNeil. And it's a 2-point game just like that. Mason for three, count it!
That's what we need.
There's your Brigham Community Pharmacy 3-pointer. And nice hustle there by Mason again.
Trevor Wilkinson in for the Bees.
Wilkinson comes in. Sumco will sit. And air ball to Kersey. And on the other end, Isaacson finishes it.
The big guy running the court, getting rewarded.
And passes out of bounds, Box Elder ball. Good defense by Buchanan.
Buchanan was right in his face.
And Box Elder returns the favor. 30-second timeout called by Coach McLaughlin. We'll be back right after this.
The following was performed by everyday riders like you. Please try it home.
Matt's a straight ripper.
I heard the turbo and I just giggling under my helmet.
Look at that.
I look like a pro. Woo-hoo!
Dude, I love that thing.
All right, welcome back out of this timeout. Clearfield has two timeouts left. Box Elder has three with just under 5 minutes left to go here in this game.
Still no fouls for this quarter.
Not a single foul called in this quarter yet. Not that there shouldn't have been some called.
Yep.
Illegal screen, foul McNeil.
He had his hip right out there in Mason, didn't he?
I want to say that's four. Is that? That's more than two on him, I thought.
That's what I thought.
Maybe I'm thinking of the girls' game.
Oh,
somebody
yeah.
else.
Yeah.
Boxell, they're trying to run a little time off the clock.
It's a good idea if they can stay in the flow of their offense and get a good shot.
Wilkinson, three ball, no good. Singletary, the rebound, going the other way.
That shot would have been huge. That would have put Boxell up by 10 had he made that.
Missed shot, Wilkinson the rebound. All right, 30-second timeout called by Box Elder. It's getting tight. We'll be right back.
Nucor is a great company. They care about their people. They care about the environment.
I've never been restricted to fall in a box. I've never been told that I can't do something.
I saw it as a great opportunity to develop a career.
You create your own destiny at Nucor.
We're building something bigger out here at Nucor. Come join us.
All right, Box Elder with the ball. 3:37 left to go in the game. 18 on the shot clock. Wilkinson will inbound. You know, this is Coach Beck's first year, and I think the boys are starting to gel with his coaching philosophies here.
Yeah.
I also like to point out our game partners, Brigham Community or Brigham City Outdoors. So if anybody's going to go skiing, go rent your equipment there. Or if you want to buy some, they'll sell them to you too. And a nice block there by Isaacson.
He thought he had it made with Mason in there.
Buchanan, three ball, no good. Isaacson the rebound and pulled out of his hands a Singletary, and Mason with a foul.
What do you think of that foul there, slowing them down?
I'm not opposed to it.
Yeah, I agree. Get the defense set up.
That's his first foul, first team foul. Getting some more size in the game here, bringing in Jepson. Mason Jepson coming in for Joran Mason. Three ball Hanson, no good. Rebound McNeil. Turn around, good shot by McNeil. Timeout called, full timeout by Clearfield. We'll be back right after this.
We've been in business here at Gillis Funeral Chapel for the last 18 years. My wife Lori and I have always felt that family is important, and when you have a family-owned funeral home, you get personal attention than you do than the big corporate funeral homes that are in the area. A lot of funeral homes will just say, here's your bag and thank you for letting us do your services, but we like to go one step further ahead.
Hi, I'm Ryan from CoverUp. We offer embroidery and screen printing to help you promote your business. We can also help you with your church or school groups, family reunions, or any other occasion that might require a t-shirt. So come in and see us at 47 South Main in Brigham City or 115 West Main in Tremonton.
Nucor is a great company. They care about their...
All right. We're coming back with 2:39 left. Box Elder with a 5-point lead. And it's been about there the whole game.
I have a feeling Wilkinson's going to hit one from deep before we end the game.
I hope so. He's not hit one yet.
Yeah.
Kersey hasn't hit one out there yet.
Uh-uh. One from Buchanan and one from Mason, I believe.
Take time off the clock.
Smart move.
There's a foul. Foul is going to be on Wohl.
Foul's on Davis Wohl.
Apparently that resets the 35-second clock.
Oh.
Second Clearfield team foul.
They still have two more fouls to give before they put Box Elder to the free throw line. Count the foul.
Yeah.
Hansen the foul. Kersey gets to go to the crumble cookie free throw line. Four on Hansen. That hurts. Hansen has been good for Clearfield.
Yeah, he's been shooting well tonight for the Falcons.
Missed the shot.
Wilkinson.
Jump ball called. Wilkinson, great effort on that. Box Elder has possession. So things roll in the right direction right now for Box Elder. 7-point lead.
35 more seconds on the shot clock. Let's go. Oh, no.
Timeout called. Clearfield. Coach Beck not too happy. He said he was over the out-of-bounds line when he got that. Doesn't matter. Timeout Clearfield. Clearfield ball. 2:15 left. We'll be right back.
We've been in business here at Gillis Funeral Chapel for the last 18 years. We do aftercare, and that's where Melanie Christie will go in and meet with a family after the services have been completed, and she'll help them with Social Security, help them file for life insurance, help them with federal government employee work. We go through credit cards. We help the family with all that transition that's coming out.
All right, we are back. Box Elder student section getting into it here.
Good thing. Kersey just got a chest bump from the coach.
Yeah. If I was coach, I'd be careful.
Yeah.
Pound for pound, I bet you Kersey's the strongest one out there. That boy is strong.
Yep.
Strong, quick, athletic, all of the above.
Yeah.
And Hansen loses it. Wilkinson has it. And a foul. Hansen, the foul. He's gone.
Oh, there you go. That's unfortunate for Clearfield.
Yeah, that's
Trace Hansen, his fifth.
I think he was probably the leading scorer tonight for Clearfield. I wish we had stats. We need Johnny. Johnny, we miss you.
Missed you, Johnny.
In for Clearfield.
Isaacson to inbound. And to Kersey.
This looks familiar.
Yeah. Kersey did it again. Downtown are no good. McNeil gets the rebound and the putback. And another foul. They cannot. This one's going to be on Cotter, and they cannot, when Isaacson's holding the ball up in their air, they cannot get up to the ball.
Clearfield team foul.
So from now on, Box Elder's in the bonus. They will shoot from the crumble cookie free throw line.
That graham cracker one's calling my name.
You better go for it.
Oh,
I think we need to get Max one of those crumble cookies down there.
If we had the stat guy here, I think that may be his first miss. He's had a good night at the line. Oh, his second miss. He's had a good night at the line.
Oh, missed that one too. B still up seven with 1:22 left. And a big scoop by Wohl for two.
Got it up over the outstretched arms of Isaacson.
And Cotter the foul. That'll put Jepson to the crumble cookie free throw line.
Fouls on Peyton Cotter, his fourth.
I think Box Elder needs to focus on, we'll see how Jepson does, but I'd like to see the ball in the hands of either Kersey or Buchanan or Wilkinson. He needs a different flavor of crumble cookie.
What else we got over there?
Better not even talk about the wedding cake.
Yeah, don't talk about that one.
That has nothing to do with basketball.
That's what the girls ate last game.
Yeah. 0 for 2 there. Kersey Bout stripped that one away from McNeil.
Those are four big misses on the last two possessions at the free throw line for Box Elder. Under a minute to go, Bruce. Here we go. Buchanan.
And Buchanan with the steal. And the block by Wohl. And a foul. They're calling this one on Bishop.
Was Cotter in the area? Cotter has four, doesn't he?
I can't remember.
Yeah.
Three on Bishop, though.
Let's close him out, Isaacson. Here we go.
There we go. He's got the right flavor crumble cookie now.
Peanut butter chocolate chip, is that one?
Just chocolate chip.
Oh, just chocolate chip.
I don't know that we had any peanut butter this time.
Yeah. Oh, Kersey.
He saved it, hustling. But unfortunately went to Bishop. Isaacson didn't like that call. Bounced off his head, and then I think he might have been right. Jones might have got to it before it went out of bounds.
Sure looked like it.
Major swap by Wilkinson.
That's beautiful.
He put that one in the bleachers.
I was thinking he's going to shoot a three down here. I guess he just is going to block a three over here.
Okay.
We're good with that.
26.2, nothing on the shot clock. And Jepson, the rebound, fouled. He's going to go to the crumble cookie free throw line. Who's it on? They got a choice. They're calling that one on Wohl, his third. 17.9 left on the clock. Bees are up by six, needs at least one of these.
That last series, Clearfield did not want anything to do with a two-point shot. All they wanted was threes.
Yeah. He got it. Box Elder by seven. Now it's a three-possession game. Caden Anderson checking in. Coming in for Kersey. And coming in is also Kaysen Anderson. Isaacson will sit. Made them both. That's the kind of crumble cookies we like.
We're ready for the student section's chant. Here
Caden
we go.
Anderson.
There they go.
They could have done that a minute ago.
Oh, yeah.
11 on the shot clock or on the clock. Into Buchanan. And that's going to be the game. They're not going to even defend him at this point. He could have got an extra 2 points. Good sportsmanship, though.
Yeah.
What a night. Came out good. Greg, I'm going to let you have it. I'm going to go talk to Coach Beck and keep talking.
Okay. Bruce is going to make his way down, and let's get a post-game report from Coach Beck. Let's hear some of his thoughts. We appreciate you guys joining us here tonight. If you watch the girls' game and the boys' game, or either or, we really appreciate it. If you get a chance, please go thank our sponsors, USU, Brigham City, Campus, Gillies Funeral, Nucor, the Joint Regeneration Place, and Cover Up, and Kent's Market. We also thank Brigham City Outdoors, Beehive, Brigham Heating and Cooling, and then Crumble Cookie at our free throw line, and then our threes. We didn't get much from Brigham City Community Pharmacy. But we are almost ready to go down there. Coach Beck's distributing some balls.
All right, Coach Beck, great win tonight, tight game all the way through. What's your thoughts on it?
I have a feeling that most of our region games will be tight games because we got a lot of good coaches and good teams that so many teams, Viewmont, Clearfield, Northridge, when you look at strength of opponent, the teams, they did like us. They played a lot of tough teams in the preseason. So we've got a lot of good teams in our region that probably don't get the respect that they do because they decided to play tough 6A teams early and took some losses. But every game is going to be so tight right now. So I was, proud of our boys.
You know, what turned you around in the second quarter? You're down, I'm trying to remember, like 6 points after one. Turn it around up by four. What was the difference there?
Just defense and rebounding. Like, guys really dialed into their defensive assignments. We rebounded. The help, the rotation was there. So, yeah, defense won it again tonight. It won it on Wednesday night, and it did it again today.
Yeah, that was great. Also, you had a 20-point second quarter, which helped.
We don't always get 20-point second quarters. Usually second quarter is the one that we put up the least amount of points in, so that's nice.
You know, it seemed to me like you got that edge in that second quarter, and then from there it was just all the way through, nice and tight all the way.
Yeah, nice battle. I felt like we responded when they hit a big shot. Our guys came down. Joran made two huge plays for us, hit a three, got the runner. So, yeah, just proud of our guys. You know, we practiced being shot ready all the time. The kid came out and he was shot ready, number two.
All right, and it was a physical game tonight, I thought. I think there was a lot of muscling around inside, and I thought you handled that very well. What's your thoughts?
It was reminiscent of some good 1980s, 1990s basketball, not the NBA that we watch anymore where nobody can touch anybody and it's all five out. So, yeah, there was a lot of banging around, especially with the bigs down in the post, a lot of contact around the rim. But, yeah, like our guys weathered that storm, so that was great.
You know, the one thing I was glad of is nobody got hurt. At least I hope nobody did anyway. Yep. I thought it was a great win.
Yeah, great win. I think when we look at it, we probably turned it over the least that we've turned it over all year. We only had two turnovers at halftime. So we were taking care of it. Now, that just guarantees us a shot on rim every possession. And when you guarantee yourself a shot on rim, you give yourself a chance for offensive rebounds and made shots. So I think that was a good deal. Thanks, Coach.
All right. I appreciate your time.
Hey, we appreciate you guys.
Thank you very much.
If you couldn't come out, it was a great crowd tonight. Shout out to our kids and to our fans. So have a good night.
All right. Thanks, Coach. Back to you, Greg.
All right. Thanks, Bruce. We, again, appreciate you guys for joining us. See if we can get the schedule up real quick for our next games. It's like we don't play again at home until we have a Bountiful home game. on the 26th. Friday the 26th will be our next broadcast. Is that what I got? Is that correct?
That sounds really, I don't have it in front of me, but that sounds like you're right.
Okay. So please join us. Spread the word.
All right. Box Elder moves on. Where did their... they are now record? 6-9.
Yep, 6-9.
Bountiful or Clearfield goes to 4-11. So great job, Box Elder boys. You know, I think Coach Beck said it right when he said, they didn't turn the ball over that much.
Yep.
And that wins ball games.
Yep. I remember that was one of your keys to the game, was to keep control of that ball.
All righty, Greg, thank you. Thank you, everyone, for watching. Please stop by. Thank our sponsors. Let them know that you watched the game here on Beehive Sports Media, and we'll be back.